For a cell to develop and function properly, it must turn on the right genes at the right time. Most of the genes in a eukaryote are located in the nucleus, within a tangle of material called chromatin. Researchers are beginning to discover that the structure of chromatin dictates whether or not a gene can be transcribed. Most of the chromatin in a cell's nucleus is highly ordered and tightly coiled. In chromatin, DNA is wrapped around several types of proteins called histones. Each of the many coiled units is a nucleosome. The histone proteins have an overall positive charge, and the DNA has a negative charge. These opposite charges attract, forming a tight association between the protein and the DNA. In this chromatin structure, the DNA of a gene is virtually inaccessible, and RNA polymerase cannot transcribe it. If the DNA is inaccessible, how does a cell turn on a gene? There are actually many different triggers for initiating transcription. As one example, a cell may receive a signal during development that results in the activation or production of a specific type of protein called a regulatory transcription factor. The regulatory transcription factor recognizes and binds to exposed sequences in the chromatin of a specific gene. It may then work in conjunction with a set of proteins that can change the chromatin structure. For example, chromatin remodeling may occur through the function of a type of protein called a chromatin remodeling complex. The action of this complex is not well understood, but the resulting structural changes expose regulatory sequences in the DNA. The regulatory sequences may be close or thousands of nucleotides away from the transcription region of the gene. For simplicity, we'll examine the naked DNA of the gene. About 30 nucleotides upstream of the transcription region is the promoter, the core regulatory sequence of the gene. Next to the promoter lies the promoter proximal element. Promoter proximal elements stimulate transcription through the binding of tissue-specific regulatory transcription factors. Enhancers are regulatory sequences that may lie thousands of nucleotides from the transcription start site. Tissue-specific regulatory transcription factors bind to enhancers to stimulate transcription. When regulatory transcription factors are bound to DNA, they interact with other transcription factors. These basal transcription factors bind to promoters. They are required for transcription to occur, but they are not cell-specific and do not provide much in the way of regulation. When all of the basal transcription factors are bound, they form a basal transcription complex. One of the basal transcription factors, called a Tata binding protein, TBP, binds to a specific sequence known as a Tata box within the promoter. The Tata binding protein allows RNA polymerase to contact DNA. The basal transcription complex then recruits RNA polymerase and transcription begins. In cell types lacking the tissue-specific regulatory transcription factors, this particular gene would not be transcribed.